What's up, guys? It's HotRide7RCT bringing you another video, and this time around I'm showcasing what to me is basically a long ass wait, but it's finally here. Final Fantasy 15 Windows Edition, or PC Edition, or however you want to call it, outside of the main consoles, of course. Now, it has been a long wait because I wanted it that way, in part because a little bit of background here before going in. As I mentioned in other videos, if you're paying attention to the videos that I've done in the past, this generation I kind of skip the whole, let's say, regular consoles, that being Xbox One and PlayStation 4. For various reasons. Number one, I have a pretty, even though it's starting to get a little long on the tooth, I've had properly built by myself so many years ago a gaming PC, a really good gaming PC. So most of the titles that were being focused outside of the exclusive for these major consoles, you can have on PC. Granted, sometimes they're not well optimized. Sometimes it takes so long for it to appear on PC. But usually, when these games arrive, they arrive with much more features, being able to up the graphics way, way higher than what you're going to find on consoles. Whether fanboys like that notion or not, that is reality. Of course, at least on the Xbox One side, being the ties with Microsoft and Windows and stuff, it's like, you know, aside from certain exclusives, which is now a thing of the past because now basically most of the biggest titles are already coming to PC, you know, are already coming to Windows. So that's like, okay, you know, no need for that. Ditto the whole Xbox One X thing, because again, the major draw, the major thing that draws me to a console, a new console, is exclusive titles. Because third parties, in the end, I'm going to be able to get, let's say, 85 to 90%. I'm going to be able to get it on PC. That's it. That's my preference, and that's basically what I've been going on for a while. Case in point, why I am so focused on the Switch and on PC side of things with this generation. Who knows? Maybe it'll change with the next one. Now, why haven't I gone into... That'll take care of... That argument will take care of why I don't have the baseline consoles and why I don't have the Pro versions or the upgraded versions. I never believe or never liked the whole concept of having this mid-generation upgrade, because I come way back from the beginning of the video game industry. You know, having your console... enjoying the games for at least 5 years, that was the time frame that was established back then, and enjoying each generation gonna have a certain amount of titles, amazing titles, and then we jump to the next one. This mid-gen upgrade thing to me is something that doesn't fly with me from the inception, because it's just spending more money. Developers don't have enough time to actually exploit that newfound power. And in my opinion, once again, my humble opinion, I know many of you won't agree, this generation started off being weak as fuck since the very beginning. You know, even though we got a boost from the previous generation, that generation was overdue for an upgrade a long, long time ago. So, let me digress, and going back to the title at hand. One of the major reasons, that's Xbox One. One of the major reasons I haven't gotten a PlayStation 4 is because the title that was going to make me buy it in the beginning was Metal Gear. And Metal Gear, as you all know, came out for the PC as well. Boom, that's it. So no real thing to go hurrying and getting the console. Then the other one I kept saying to myself was Final Fantasy. I said, that one I'm never going to get, so I'm going to have to go and bite the bullet and buy a PlayStation 4. And here we are, a year after the game came out, we have it on PC. And I have gone talking way too long, and this is about the PC. How is the PC version, and how is this Final Fantasy 15? Many are extremely divided on this game. I was talking with my partner, AfroSoul, the other half of RCT, and we had this discussion about Final Fantasy and RPGs in general. She is super stoked with Project Octopath Traveler coming out. That's another thing completely. But the point is, we were talking about Final Fantasy as a whole, and I expressed to her that it's funny that I never thought that I was going to live in an age where a game like Final Fantasy, that franchise, is divided, in my opinion, in three generations already. The first generation being what I call the beginners, or the hardcore audience, the one that started from the beginning and saw the evolution of the Final Fantasies as a series. Then we get the middle, which is the new generation, that are seeking something like the latest tech or whatever, graphics focus, which happened like from Final Fantasy VII onward. And then around Final Fantasy X-2, it was all about, you know, starting the whole Lightning series and stuff. It's like the hipster version, you know, like the last, you know, generation is kind of like more shallow in terms of what they want from a Final Fantasy, and they're getting, you know, basically that. So I'm a little apprehensive going into Final Fantasy 15 because the whole system changed. We're not playing a baseline or mainline Final Fantasy in the sense of the combat. The combat is very different. Granted, this Final Fantasy has been wrought with incredible development problems and issues. This game has been in development forever. It was even thought that it was never going to come out. It started off as Final Fantasy 13 versus something like that. It was going to come years before, but they somehow managed to bring it out after all, and this is what we got, Final Fantasy 15. The combat is very different. It's more action-oriented. It's not turn-based like we're used to. We don't have magic as we are used to having, where you learn spells and you have it and you can just, you know, span that fire, that thundada, or whatever. Here, it's more meticulous. It's more... You have menus and inventory and a whole bunch of stuff, but it's more action-oriented. Is it going to be any good? I don't know. But man, oh man, it's beautiful on the PC. Now, I'm going to show you. I'm going to go into the gameplay screen now because I've talked way too much. It's already 8 minutes in and I'm blabbering here like crazy. I'm going to say this once. I've had to dial down the settings to show you, or to have a recording of this, because this is a very stressful game on a regular PC, regular gaming PC. This is meant to exploit and take advantage of the latest graphics cards, the latest CPUs. This is done with the Luminous engine, which is very, very taxing in itself. So I am going to be playing this preview, because this is a showcase preview. This is the beginning of the game. I haven't gotten the time yet to basically go in and enjoy the game like I want to. I'm gonna start after I finish doing these videos. But so far what I see is kind of good. In the end, I'll do an update video to tell you how I like the game. This video is more like, what are the differences between the regular version and this one? I can't say because I don't have a PlayStation 4, but I've seen plenty of reviews and YouTube videos on the graphics and stuff like that, so I can tell the difference from far. So without further ado, and sorry for all that talk. By the way, you might, let me go here, should I start from the beginning? I don't know if I should start from the beginning because, it's gonna take too much time, and the loading is super crazy. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna load this chapter, which is basically after the cinematics and all that stuff, the game where, you know, where the game releases control to the player for the very first time. Again, this is not to show all the complexities of the game, because there's a lot of game here. Plus, this version has all the DLC. It has mod support. It has Steamworks support as well. It has a whole bunch of stuff that's impossible to cover in a few minute video. What else? Oh my god. This is the largest, by far the largest game that I've had on PC, due to the fact that it has and includes a high resolution texture pack, which is 63 gigs, along with the 85, that's over 140 something gigs. Thank God that I got beforehand, I got my 3 terabyte drive upgrade, which I have now for all my RCT stuff. But man, oh man, it's a huge title. And of course, the version that I have is on Steam. You can also pick this up on Origin, for whatever reason, I don't understand, but you can get it on Origin. And what was the other place you could get it? I guess on the Square Enix store? I don't know. All I know is that the PC version had different versions that you can purchase, and depending on the version that you get special bonuses as well. So you will see this a little jerky. At least on the video, it's gonna seem that way, because I'm using the same CPU that I'm using for playing the game or running the game in 1440p, no less. I'm using it to record this, so yeah, it's gonna look a little wonky, but believe me, it's not the game. It's because it's recording. Now, I could also go, to make it a little easier on the processor, I could probably bring down the resolution, but nah, that would mean a lot of adjustments, and we're not going to spend time with that. Now, as we are here, let me just show you some of the stuff that you actually get with this version. Now, I noticed I didn't know what to expect, because I didn't know the contents of the DLC and the expansions and stuff like that. But one thing that I noticed is that you get a couple of weapons here, which are pretty cool. I'm going to equip the Ragnar here. I'm going to equip Kai Bog here. Do I have this sword? That's going to be okay. Accessories. Whole bunch of accessories here, which I'm assuming this doesn't come with the standard game, but I guess this is from the DLCs. And of course, because of the Steam version, as you can see, the list is long in terms of clothing and stuff, but the one that strikes me the most funny, of course, is the Half-Life costume that you get for getting the Steam version. And here you have it. You can actually have all the gang dressed with this. Oh, wait a second. This one doesn't have one? Okay. That's weird. I thought that you could have all of them. I guess not. Okay, that's for Noctis, I guess. So you have the Half-Life suit, but you also have all the gear from the expansions and stuff. This one right here, Magitek, I don't know what the hell this is, but man, it looks freaking amazing. I'm gonna try that out later on. As you can see, the detail of the graphics and stuff, and I'm not even using like a high percentage of basically what this game can do graphically. what you're seeing here is basically a step or a couple of steps higher than what you would find on a PS4 or PS4 Pro. Of course, running in the little limitation that I explained just now, that I'm using the same CPU for recording as I use for the game. So
what to buy?
I'm gonna run into here because I know this is gonna trigger. It's gonna trigger a mission. Since I can't buy anything, I'm broke. I don't have any money.
We've expended the last of our funds on the repairs. I suggest we confer with Cindy.
Broken down and flat broke.
Adding insult to injury.
So we're gonna do this real quick.
Old man's in for both after charging us that much.
You know, this is stuff that you probably already seen in other videos. But I absolutely love how everything looks, man. As you can see, the Cactuar suit, which is something I believe is part of the mods and stuff that you can get in the game. Square already said that they were going to release complete mods or the ability. You can already perform mods, but they're going to be releasing updates and patches to that to make it more, as they said, give you more freedom in what you can do. There's not going to be any censoring. You can do whatever. You can go crazy on the game. They just want people to keep playing the game for a long time, which I have to commend them for that.
She ain't going to be ready for a while. Y'all need something?
I'm going to go for a loan because that's going to trigger this mission.
Hate to ask, but can we borrow some cash?
Oh, now I get it. This must be what Papa meant when he said he was gonna teach them boys a lesson. Told me he ought to have y'all take care of some ornery varmints that have been causing a ruckus around here.
Now, I have the voices in English, but to me they,
if you're up to the challenge. How about it?
Some of them are cringeworthy, and
all according
I'm
to
gonna
Sid's
be playing
plan.
This proper with
I
Japanese voiceovers and
teach
subtitles.
Teach him not to underestimate us.
Because that's just... No, I'm sorry, but no, not gonna happen.
But don't go running around after dark. The demons are liable to rip y'all to shreds. Here, this ought to be enough for a place to stay. Just between us, though. Don't tell Papa.
All right, so here we go. Going to the mission. Let me change back. Actually, no. Let me leave him with the... Half-Life suit. That is original to this version.
We're out of here. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we gotta kill some scorpions and stuff and collect
money.
Looks
like we found our first targets. Ready, knocked.
Excellent work. On we go.
So basically, the combat is a mixture of action, you know, fighting, attacking, and parrying, and blocking, and all that stuff. And depending on the timing, it's going to be more advanced stuff is going to happen. Now, one of the things that I'm looking most forward to is seeing how, in this setting or with this power, how the summons are going to look. Because I just absolutely love summons in Final Fantasies.
They aren't gonna know what hit them. Let's do this.
that one very well either. The gear. There's other costumes as well that you can mess around with. There's still a little jerkiness in the graphics. I don't know if that's related to driver issues or stuff like that. As you can see, it sometimes it flickers, but so far it's not getting in the way of the game, so I'm cool with it. Let's leave the dude like this and change the exosuit back to his regular clothing.
We'll be done in no time.
And let's go over to this side.
Let's get on with it.
So we can finish this. The first side quest, or I don't know if it's part of the main quest, but...
So, where are we headed anyway?
Nowhere until the repairs are done. Then we head for Golden Key.
Then after that, we hop a boat, and before you know it, lover boy's hitched.
Wait for car repairs, then wedding bells in the air. Got it.
Come on, let's run.
Almost there. Give it your all. See ya.
I'm using the wrong button for lock on. No wonder.
Hey, now! Warp strike to catch our guard!
Who could this be? Hello?
Hey, it's Cindy. How goes the hunting?
Actually, we just finished.
That's great, because I got one more hunt for y'all. Only this time, it's for a person. Fella named Dave went off, and we ain't heard from him since. Reckon he staked out a spot in an old shack nearby.
Old shack?
My God, that voice is driving me insane.
We'll take a look.
What did Cindy say?
Needs us to find some Dave guy.
He went missing?
Not missing. Said he's holed up in that shack.
Let's go check out the shack and see what's going on. I haven't even bothered to heal the guys.
This.
Locked! Get out of here! You okay?
We are now.
Spoke too soon.
I'm going all out.
Just don't get too carried away.
Don't mention it.
need to get it with the timing a bit better because I need to heal. Damn it. Using combat, that's why. I didn't bother to check how to use them, that's the problem. There it is.
Shack over there.
Well, that's gonna be all for now, guys. Sorry I'm gonna leave it on a cliffhanger, but to be honest, I've gone a little too long here. I just wanted to showcase the game for you guys, so I hope you guys enjoyed it. This is a quick view, as quick as I could, actually. It was a little longer than quick, but you guys get the idea. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please like and subscribe. Wait for the next one coming up, which is going to be Backlog Blues. I'm going to be doing Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare 2. So, like and subscribe. And if not, at least, at the very least, share the video. I really appreciate it. It goes a long way to helping me, get out there. A small YouTuber, and, I can get any help I can get. So, thanks a lot. See you guys and peace.